Student friends, in last week we studied the two oscillators. One is Hartley oscillator and second one is Colpitts oscillator. Both are radio frequency oscillator that generates the frequency in a radio frequency range. Both uses inductance and capacitance in a tank circuit. So that's why those are also called as the LC oscillator. They generate the sine wave, so that's why those are also referred as the sinusoidal oscillator. Student friends, let me proceed to study another type of oscillator known as Peary's crystal oscillator. Before going to start directly with the Peary's crystal oscillator, let us prepare some basic things which are needed to study that particular Peary's crystal oscillator. Friends, Peary's crystal oscillator uses a piezoelectric crystal. And that's why it's better to study at first the meaning of piezoelectric crystal. And to study that piezoelectric crystal, let us study the piezoelectric effect. The equivalent structure of the piezoelectric crystal and how this crystal replaces inductance or capacitor in Hartley and Colpitts oscillator circuitry so as to turn them into Peary's crystal oscillator. Especially, Colpitts oscillator is preferred so that our crystal is going to act as an inductor there so as to get a stable frequency oscillations in that particular oscillator circuit. So friends, let me begin with understanding of the piezoelectric crystal. Student friends, there are some naturally available crystals which have the peculiar property. Out of them, some of the crystals are piezoelectric crystal, Rochel salt, tourmaline are the material, or quartz is another example. All those possesses the piezoelectric property. What are the materials? Rochel salt, tourmaline crystal, quartz crystal are the naturally available crystals which possesses the property of piezoelectric effect. Now, what is piezoelectric effect? Friends, when mechanical pressure is applied to such a crystals between two opposite phases, electronic charges are going to be developed across remaining two opposite phases. Means mechanical pressure is going to be converted into electrical charges. This property of the crystal is known as piezoelectric effect. Reverse is also possible, friends. If you apply electric voltage across two phases, then the crystal may go deformation to change its dimensions. That is known as anti-piezoelectric effect. First one is piezoelectric effect. It means if you apply the mechanical pressures across two phases of the crystal, then across opposite phases, electric charges are developing. So that is known as piezoelectric effect. Now conversely, if you apply electrical voltage across two phases, then the crystal undergoes the deformation and it will change its shape and size as by changing its dimensions. This is known as anti-piezoelectric effect. This property is being used in a crystal oscillator. Let us study the crystal equivalent. Friends, we are here going to consider a quartz crystal. Quartz crystal is cut in a suitable plane which has different axes which are naturally available. One is electric axis, second one is mechanical axis, and third one is optical axis. If you apply mechanical pressure across mechanical axis, electrical charges are developed across electrical axis by undergoing the piezoelectric effect. Conversely, if you apply electric voltage across electrical axis, the mechanical vibrations are set up across the mechanical axis. This is anti-piezoelectric effect. Additional property quartz possesses, and that is associated with the optical axis that can be used in optics. Friends, this quartz crystal has a hexagonal pyramid in a set. It is hexagonal pyramid in a set. If that crystal is cut suitably in a particular plane, we are going to get different cuts of the quartz crystal. For example, if you cut crystal in XY plane, you will get Z cut crystal. If you cut crystal in XZ plane, you will get Y cut crystal. And if you cut crystal in YZ plane, you will get X cut crystal. Depends upon the plane in which that crystal is going to cut, you are going to get the variety of the cuts. Those can be used for the different applications. Friends, that crystal is equivalent with the parallel combination of L and C. It is going to act as a series resonance circuitry, as well as it is going to act as a parallel resonance circuitry. That is its specialty. Let us see details of the same. Friends, piezoelectric crystal and its equivalent circuit. There are naturally available crystals like quartz, Rochelle salt, tourmaline crystal, etc. When they are applied with mechanical pressure, they generate electrical charges across it. It is known as the piezoelectric effect. Similarly, when AC voltage is applied across them, it generates the mechanical deformation in the crystal that is known as anti-piezoelectric effect. These crystals have electrical axis, mechanical axis, and also the optical axis. Different cuts are taken, that is X cut in YZ plane, Y cut in XZ plane, and Z cut in XY plane. The AC equivalent of crystal is represented as a series resonating LCR circuit. Look at here. So this is actually the crystal, piezoelectric crystal, which is represented in a symbolic form, which is cut suitably But actually, originally it is available in hexagonal pyramid in a cell. Hexamine. After getting cut, it will appear like this, and this is symbolically crystal is represented. The equivalent of this particular chord crystal is represented here. What is here? This crystal is combination of series combination of L, C, R, or parallel combination of L, C, R. That is its specialty. Here, look at here. L, C, S means series capacitor, and its internal resistors are. When it is going to be connected in parallel aspect, L and R in series, whereas CP that is comes in parallel. How the reactance of this crystal varies with frequency? As frequency increases, reactance also increases, becomes start resonating from particular frequency that increases, reaches to maximum, depend upon its assigned L and C. After that, it decreases. Look it here. And goes to omega P. Omega means parallel resonance. Hence, it is going to undergo change in reactance, produces the series as well as parallel resonance in the crystal. As a being, crystal is combination of L and series capacitance C or L and parallel capacitance CP. Let us proceed further. From this equivalent circuit, when it is going to act as a series resonating circuitry, which were represented here, we are considering L, C, S and R for series resonance. Let us see what happens. In case of series resonance, the reactance of that particular circuit is given as omega S, S for series, omega SL minus 1 upon omega SC, S. At resonance, its impedance is 0. And impedance is given as omega L minus 1 upon omega C. S is the symbol represented only for the series resonance. From this equation, we can write it omega SL is equal to omega S 1 upon omega SC. By performing mathematical manipulations, that is omega S is transferred to the left side, so as to get omega square S is equal to omega is equal to 1 upon L into CS. Taking square roots on both sides, omega S is equal to omega 1 upon square root of L CS. But omega S is equal to 2 pi F. Therefore, 2 pi Fs is equal to 1 upon root of LCS. Fs is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root of LCS. In general, F is equal to 1 upon twice pi root of LC. S is the symbol used only for the series resonance. Friends, this is the formula for frequency of series resonating crystal oscillator. We can say that the right arm of series resonance circuit act as a purely inductive circuit. but left arc is going to act as a totally capacitive circuit. Meaning thereby, okay, this is a purely inductive circuit, whereas this one is purely capacitive circuit that we want to suggest. For inductive circuit, we have calculated the frequency now at resonance. Therefore, when it is going to act as a parallel resonance circuit, capacitive reactance plays the very vital role. For parallel resonance, we can write it, the reactance of same circuitry, we can write it as omega PL minus 1 upon omega PCS equal to 1 upon omega PCP. Here P is the symbol that is used for parallel resonance and S is for series. Therefore, by performing mathematical manipulations, omega PL equal to 1 upon omega PCS plus 1 upon omega PCP. 1 upon omega P is taken common so that we can write it. Omega PL equal to 1 upon omega P into bracket 1 upon CS plus 1 upon CP. Take LCM. That 1 upon omega is transferred to the left side so as to get omega square P into L equal to 1 upon CS plus 1 upon CP, which one can write it as CSCP, CS plus CP upon CSCP, and that's equal to 1 upon C, where C is CSCP upon CS plus CP, because CS and CP are connected in parallel. So omega square P is equal to 1 upon LC. But do remember, C is equal to CSCP upon CS plus CP. Taking square root on both sides, omega P is equal to 1 upon square root of LC. Omega P is equal to 2 pi FP. That's equal to 1 upon root of LC. FP is equal to 1 upon twice pi root of LC. This is the formula for equivalent crystal at parallel resonance. Thus, what we are going to prove here, we are going to prove here that the series and parallel resonating frequencies are same. That is Fs equal to Fp. Thus we can say a crystal when connected in any arm of the radio frequency oscillator, either in inductive circuit or in a capacitive circuit, it resonates with the frequency determining circuit and generates the oscillations in megahertz. Because what we proved here? Here we proved that crystal is going to generate the frequency either it is connected in the inductive mode or it is connected in a capacitive mode. When it generates the frequency in a megahertz, this property of crystal equivalence can be used so as to construct the Pirie's crystal oscillator. Friends, now let us consider Pirie's crystal oscillator. Thus, with this particular background of crystal, its cuts, its equivalent circuit to be going to act as a inductive reactance or capacitive reactance and gets resonates, provides the same frequency determined by the tank circuit. By using this property, we are going to construct the Pirie's crystal oscillator. So, thus, from AC equivalent crystal, a crystal when connected in any arm of the radio frequency oscillator, either in inductive circuit or in capacitive circuit, it will resonate with the frequency determining circuit and generates the oscillations in megahertz. So, designed oscillator is known as Peris crystal oscillator. It is the oscillator that uses the crystal with proper cut that produces electrical and mechanical oscillations with stable frequency, having the property of resonating to produce the maximum frequency. Whatever crystal we have studied, it is to be connected either to act as an inductance or it is going to act as a capacitor in any radio frequency oscillator like Hartley oscillator or Kolpitt oscillator. Generally, in Hartley oscillator, it is connected in inductive arm. But when in Kolpitt oscillator, if it is to be used, it is connected in a capacitor arm. The Peris crystal oscillator consists of a transistor which is biased in active region by voltage divider biasing network formed by R1 and R2. Emitter resistance RE and emitter bypass capacitor CE act as a emitter resistor and bypass capacitor to produce self bias to BZE. RFC equal to RL can act as a load on BZE that avoids high frequency short circuit current to reach to BZE. Tank circuit contains C1 and C2 in series and crystal as an inductor. Thus, crystal is connected in a tank circuit or Kolpitt oscillator to form a Peris crystal oscillator. Means when we are using Kolpitt oscillator, crystal is connected in an inductive branch. But if you are using crystal in a Hartley oscillator, it is going to act as a capacitor. A BZE in a common emitter mode produces 180 degree phase shift and tank circuit produces 180 degree phase shift, so that net phase shift is either 0 degree or 360 degree to get a positive feedback. By satisfying the condition of KAV greater than or equal to 1, when HF equal to C2 upon C1, oscillations are sustained at a resonance to give a stable frequency oscillations. Here, input and output capacitors couples signal to the tank circuit and the BZE. Friends, crystal oscillator generates the stable frequency oscillations by satisfying Barkhausen criteria with phase difference of 360 degree and KAV should be greater than or equal to 1. Such a circuit is represented here. So this is the Peris crystal oscillator. This is the crystal which we have studied. It is connected in an inductive arm. Originally, try to remember, it is a Kolpitt oscillator. Here is C1, C2, centrally tapped, it is grounded. RE is emitter bypass capacitor, RE is emitter bypass resistor, C is emitter bypass capacitor, RFC, it is a radio frequency choke, is going to act as a RL. This is RB1, RB2 or R1, R2 going to act as a voltage divider biasing network. It biases the BZE or its operating point exactly on the center of the load line, so that it is going to act as a very faithful amplifier. Routinely, the tank circuit works as per the tank circuit of Colpitts oscillator and generates the oscillations very stable in megahertz. So this is what we can call it as, it is a crystal oscillator or Peary's crystal oscillator. Friends, that's all about today's lecture. Next time we'll go for the one more oscillator.